All right, so now in Premiere Pro, we already have our video looped here that we wanted to output to Square Video. So let's see how we do it for Premiere Pro. So you have your composition here, which I'll check the settings, is 23.976, 1920 by 1080. And all you do is you right click on the screen here, which is a project screen, and you're gonna do new item sequence. And once you do that, you can click on, instead of sequence presets, you click on settings, and instead of QuickTime DV, because right now they have this lock, right? You can't click on anything. So then you go to custom, right? And then you change this to 23.976 to match this guy. And then on the frame size, you will also do 1080 by 1080 because it's normally 1920 by 1080. So if you want to make a square, it's 1080 by 1080. If it was 1280 by 720, it would be 720 by 720. And you do square pixels, you do progressive scan, and then you leave it at that. And you can call this square video PR for Premiere, and then click OK. So now you have that here, and then the best thing for you to do, or easiest thing, is to bring it down here to the bottom of this thing, because now it's stacked. So all you got to do is just click on this guy here, Apple C, paste it over here, Apple V, and then I will turn off the audio so it doesn't get crazy with the sound. But that's all you got to do. See, now you got this awesome square video for Facebook here on Premiere, but you still got to output it, right? So then you press Apple M to output it, and you see it looks a little bit weird now, and it's telling me to do it for the Android tablet, which is not what I want. So what I normally do is I'll click all the way down here to YouTube, and I will go to 1080p 23.96. it is H.264 here because it is for Facebook. And then normally this box here, this chain link, is checked. You uncheck this box and you take out the 1920, you put 1080, and look at the square on the left now, how it's gonna format perfectly for social media. Great, right? So then you do have progressive scan, square pixels, which is great. You do wanna always check on render at maximum depth, because it's gonna give you the best quality image, and click that right here too. And then the bit rate for Facebook, I think it can handle, I don't know, 14, maybe 15 here, with the VVR2 pass. And then you just click on where you want to save the video and click save, and then just click on export or click on a render cube, and it would export it for you. All right, thanks again, bye bye.